morning to you, YouTube. Okay, so Wednesday the 25th of March 2020. Yeah. So I've just got up, come downstairs, the usual morning routine, black coffee, barefoot walking, earthing, grounding on the cold grass. Always the way I like to start the day. And I've just been told that we're all on a total lockdown now, unless you have to go out for essential food or medical supplies. So here we go. This video is to help people who are staying at home, who still want to connect with nearby nature. Of course it's about that. What else is it going to be about? So all I can go with is from my perspective. So I'm in a house that has a garden, which is awesome. So I get to come out to the garden and look at this cherry blossom tree, get my feet on the grass. But I'm also mindful that a lot of people don't have gardens. However, if I can assume that everyone has a window in there, wherever they live or wherever they are right now, I'm going to roll more with that style. So, okay. Obviously, if you've got a garden, I like to do the barefoot earthing and grounding on the grass, get them electrons through your feet, mycobacterium, vaccinal bacteria from the soil. That's quite good for relaxing your, boost your immune system, all that kind of stuff. Through this video, I'm going to continuously suggest you Google certain things. So for this one, I would just suggest Google barefoot earthing grounding for health and well-being, something like that. Loads of stuff about that. There's a movie on YouTube, the Earthing Movie, I always promote. There's a book called Earthing. Loads of people doing it right now. Anyway, back to the indoor vibes. I know that a lot of people are going to be spending a lot of time looking at screens. So what I do is I go from screen time to native time. So I'll be looking at a screen, a tablet, phone, laptop, TV. And then I'll look out the window, look at the sky. I'll be looking for the clouds. If there's no clouds, I'll just simply look at the blue sky. Birds will fly past. I'll look out, there's bees, flies, all that kind of stuff. Just loads of different things. Just simply look at something that's natural. It calms the brain. Here's the next little Google bit. Google attention restoration theory. Hello. We call that the TikTok bumblebee. We'll get onto TikTok in a minute. But yeah, attention restoration theory is really spending time in nature to restore mental fatigue. So you're going to get a lot of mental fatigue now if you're stuck indoors looking at screens all day. So simply looking at the sky, the clouds, anything natural, just calms your brainwaves. But don't take my word for it. Just Google it, attention restoration theory. It's by Kaplan and Kaplan. So there's loads of stuff like that, positive psychology. So have a little Google of that. That's really good. So views of nature. And it doesn't, when you think of views in nature, you think, oh, the wilderness, the waterfalls, all that stuff you see on Instagram and the talk now. But no, simply looking at a cherry blossom tree like this, or if you've got no greenery or plants, just look at the sky and the clouds and the birds. That'll do the trick at this time. Don't look directly at the sun, but when we've got clear skies, whoa, the night time, looking at the stars and the moon as well. What I would suggest is various points through the day, not just the morning or the night, just keep doing it, keep looking out of the sky, out of the clouds, looking at the birds. Also, listen. Just turn everything off a few points in the day and just listen out your window to different bird sounds, different nature sounds. You might be able to hear the bees buzzing around it. You might, if you live near the coast, seagulls, different birds. You will be able to hear some nature sounds, I hope. Okay, so going back to the indoors, there's a concept called biophilic design. If you Google that, the main things about it is getting natural light into your home and views of nature. So you either views of nature from looking out the window or inside the house via like flowers and plants. Check that out. That is awesome. Biophilic design. Okay, so I've covered a few things. Okay, biomimicry. So when you are looking at the screens, if you can watch some like YouTube videos of forests or waterfalls or anything nature style, that's good for you as well. That's called biomimicry. So you, even if you want to pause my annoying voice, because it's a bit more, like 95% of people like it, but a few people can't stand it, so fair enough. Turn the volume off and just look at this cherry blossom tree for a few minutes, this video. That's biomimicry. So if you're watching this on YouTube now and you're thinking, shut up, lad, I just want to watch them cherry blossoms fall on your phone, turn the volume down and just watch. That'll be good for you as well. But have a little Google, biomimicry. There we go. So going back onto TikTok. Yeah, this is an app that you probably all know about. It used to be just for kids, loads of adults on there now. A lot of people are going on there, documenting their, you know, journey in the self-isolation. People try and do loads of funny videos, make each other laugh, help each other. It's gone like that, it's helping each other, mainly with entertainment, laughter, obviously. And I'm putting the nature stuff on there as well, so check a few of them out. I'm sure some of them make you laugh and give you some nature inspiration, but obviously I'm lucky enough to have a nice cherry blossom tree in the grass and the sky, but simply looking out the window, cloud gazing is the one, stargazing. Whoa, if you can do that, you will. What's that there? A little bed. So yeah, check that out. What else? I'm trying to think if I've missed anything else. I think the most important thing is, if you've got any like questions, I know Gary Vee always has Q&A, but it's important. This is, it seems to be like, you know, my time now, so I'm well into the nearby nature connection anyway. So LinkedIn would be good, email michaelvj.jones@gmail.com. and also I'm sharing some of my old content out there as inspiration for the summer for local nearby nature connection, and also just to show like love, appreciation, gratitude. So that's the reason I'm sharing some of that stuff now, because I know we can't go out, but I'm thinking August, you know, connecting with the nearby nature in whatever region you are, that's what